chest training 101. Even if you're a new person in the gym, this video is for you. Walking into the gym, you see a lot of guys with well-built chest. In fact, you know, when you think of the word bodybuilder, what comes to mind? Probably somebody with a very strong bench press, somebody with a full developed chest muscles. So you need to go in with a game plan right off the bat. You're a beginner in the gym, just walking in, or if you're someone that just needs a nice refresher, it's good to have a refreshing course, kind of a crash course on chest, on basic chest training. So that's exactly what I'm gonna be bringing to you today. It's gonna be chest today, and then from here on out, we're gonna be talking about advanced training, competition training, power training. I'm gonna do this for each subsequent body part. Today, because everyone loves chest, we're starting off with chest training 101 with me, Steve Cook, the BMOC, Swoldier Nation. Let's build a chest. So make sure you're always warm when you're coming into the gym. I've done my treadmill today already. Now I'm just warming up, do some flies, your rotator cuffs. You can also do these on a cable. Cables work really well. This workout that we're gonna be doing today, I'm sticking to basic movements. We're gonna be doing the bench press. We're gonna be doing an incline press. We're gonna be doing a fly, a dip motion for our lower chest, and then also a dumbbell pullover to help that rib cage expansion. Now that's kind of a controversial topic, but I think especially those younger guys out there starting to get in the gym, doing those rib cage expansions will really help set the foundation to build a big chest. So it's gonna start off with basic raw movements to build that muscle in there. Using good form always, we're gonna be talking about the proper form to use, but getting into the gym, setting the proper foundation. It's not about the weights here today. It's gonna be about the form. We're gonna go heavy, and you should go heavy, but always with the proper form, keeping that tension on the chest. It's that mind-muscle connection that we always talk about. One last thing I do before, just a couple push-ups to get that blood in there. Get some blood in the triceps too. So today, it's just gonna be basic. I'm not gonna talk about my specific training and what I need to do. It's gonna be for you guys. So give this one a shot. It's gonna be for the first couple months you train, even up to a year. If you're just starting out training, doing this workout, switching it up with barbells for dumbbells, and even a machine in there, especially if you're injured, a machine is a good way to work around that injury because it keeps it in that same plane the entire time. But for all purposes, start out with this. When you start noticing imbalances or weak areas that aren't coming up as fast, start doing those first in your workout. And I'll kind of talk to you as I go through this workout about how to train those weak areas. You know, if your inner chest is lacking, what to do. But for me and for you guys today, just basic chest 101. All right, first up on our list, flat barbell bench press. If you allow yourself to use too much anterior delt or tricep, you won't notice that you're building a bigger chest. The purpose of this exercise is, if you do it right, to build an overall developed chest. You know, some bodybuilders like Sergio Olivier just trained with this one exercise and had, you know, a well-developed chest. Now, you and I probably aren't quite that gifted, so we're gonna need other exercises in there. But starting off, this is the best place to start. It's what most people know. When they think chest, they think bench press. When doing a bench press, make sure you keep your elbows out wide. Start tucking in here, it's gonna be a lot of triceps, a lot of shoulders and a lot of triceps. By keeping your elbows out wide, keeping that arcing motion in the chest, fully filling it, chest out, squeezing at the top, lowering it slowly. It shouldn't bounce off that chest. You know, as it gets heavier, it might bounce a little, but really control down there, touch and go. You know, it's so important for those novice bodybuilders or anyone in the gym to stress form first. So it's all the way down and then back up to chin level. But it's gonna be more about form, really stressing using lighter weight, relatively lighter weight, and not bouncing it, really focusing on the movement in the chest. Make sure you're blowing out on the concentric portion. Hopefully, you have yourself or will be getting yourself a little black book, or any color book for that matter. I say little black book because all my workout logs have been black. There you record your weights, your repetitions, your sets, your exercises, how you were feeling that day. Keeping track of all these things will really just speed up the process of reaching your goals. You know, it's always about progressively training. You know, you don't want to get, you know, stiff and rigid. You want to be very flexible. You know, you can see a lot of big bodybuilders, big muscle-bound bodybuilders, able to do all sorts of crazy stretching movements because they train with full range of motion. Go only to failure on your very last set of a certain exercise. Bench press, our third working set, we're going to failure on this next one. Alright, third and final set. This one is the big one. We're going to failure on this. Keep in mind that good form. We're using chest. We don't want our anterior delts to start taking over. Slow it down if you have to. Lighten up if you have to. Next up, incline press. That is gonna be our friend here, the incline dumbbell press. Now, a lot of the times you'll find me using dumbbells for incline. I just really like the way I can isolate each arm. For flat, you know, it's such a standard to use barbell on flat bench press. People always ask you, how much do you bench press? So it's, you know, a lot of people use flat barbell. I usually do flat 2-to-1. I'll do barbell, you know, twice as much as I do dumbbell on flat. For incline, it's just about reversed. I do incline dumbbell about twice as many times as I do it with a barbell. We're gonna be doing one warm-up set, and you'll notice here the bench press isn't at too high of an angle. You know, I would say it's about 20 degrees there. Each subsequent set after this, we're gonna be raising it a little bit more. Again, keeping your elbows wide, squeezing with that chest, really feel it up here. Start building that clavicular portion of the chest. Ninety seconds in between these. Nice and slow at the bottom. Pause. Back up. Second working set on here. I've increased the weight 10 pounds. You want to make sure you're controlling the weight and the weight's not controlling you. All right, money set, last set, best set. Always staying about 80% full of strict form here, even though we're going to failure. It's not about the weight, it's about our muscle. Like always, form strict. 80% of perfect, and get your mind wrapped around it. Let's go. Here, I'm gonna be working on my upper chest. Like I said, if you're a beginner, you wanna make sure you don't neglect any areas. Not quite as high of an incline. Again, we're gonna be doing just one warm-up set. Three working sets. When you wear that V-neck, I know I've said it before, when you wear that scoop neck, when you wear that V-neck Swoldier Nation shirt, you get that top peak pointing out, you know, that top chest looking out. It's a fully developed, wide, squared chest, full from all angles. Boom! You know you like that. Second working set, again, big arcing angles, slight bend in the elbows. We don't want to be straight here. Slight bend all the way down, and I like to turn out those dumbbells, stretch behind your head, finish off above your eyes. Stretch it out in between. Start feeling like a bodybuilder. or a men's physique guy, whatever you prefer.
Last set.
And that does it for our, that's our third chest exercise today. A little bit of an incline, dumbbell flies. Next up, it's gonna be a modified dip for chest. Now, this is gonna really, like I said, stretch that lower outer area. How it's performed is by leaning forward, taking triceps out of it. Triceps, a tricep dip, you perform straight up and down. When you start leaning forward, you incorporate a lot more chest all the way down, stopping before you lock out. Stopping about right here, squeezing. We're gonna jump right into it. First working set, I have a 40 pound dumbbell. Now if you have a belt, you'll see a lot of times a belt with a chain attached that you can hook on plates, you know, whether it's a 45 or even kettlebells you can hook on there and do them with. I'm gonna show you guys how to do it with just a dumbbell here. Just squeeze it between my toes, bring my knees up, get to work. Second working set. I didn't get 12 on my first one, I only got 11, so I'm gonna stick with the same weight. It's perfectly fine to do that. Really making sure you're stretching all the way down this far at the bottom. Last set, I'm sitting at the same weight at 40 pounds here. Next week, I'm gonna try to do 45 pounds on my last set. Last exercise in our chest routine 101 is gonna be dumbbell pullovers. Now this is really used to expand that rib cage, really set that chest up for looking for building it to its maximum. By you know, like I said, it's a little bit controversial, but by expanding that rib cage, especially if you're younger, use these dumbbell pullovers to build up that thorax, to build up that pectoralis. Find a flat bench, and you're gonna be laying your shoulders across it. For this first one, just grab a really light, for those beginners out there, 20 to 30 pounds maximum. I'm just gonna grab 50 pounds and do a warm-up set. What you're gonna wanna do, take the dumbbell, set it flat on the bench next to you. Our shoulders are gonna be the only thing that touch the bench. I'm gonna keep that chest high. Like I said, nothing else is touching that bench except for your shoulder blades. Head's hanging off the back of it. With your palms facing the ceiling, just grab that dumbbell, straight arm, you know, not quite locked out, but just about locked out. And as you lower the weight, you're gonna keep those elbows straight, lowering all the way, and as you do, you're gonna drop your hips, sink your hips into it as well, dropping your arms back as far as you can behind your head, and then back up to the top. Just really feeling that stretch in the pecs. All right, set two. Get one more set there. I'm gonna stay right there with weight. Make sure I'm sinking those hips, fully stretching. This one you'll notice, triceps. You'll start getting a little bit of a tricep pump on here. One of the reasons I've always loved doing these is because you get those great serratus muscles. Feel from here all the way down into that chest, coming across here into the ribs. It's a great way to finish off that chest. As we move on, you know, there's gonna be more videos. We're gonna do a power chest segment. We're gonna do one for advanced training, then one also for competition training. So you're gonna see so many shocking principles, ways to get that chest to grow if you're just not seeing it. If it's one of those weak areas, you know, train it first in the week before when you're fresh. You know, It's fun. Chest is one of those things that nothing gives you more pleasure than going into the gym and building that big chest. You know, it's one of the first things you notice on a bodybuilder. People always ask, you know, how strong you are. They always ask, what do you bench? I still get that to this day. Are you a strong guy? I say, yeah, I'm all right. What do you bench? People always ask that. For those of you wondering, my bench press and my prime was 440. when I was playing football. Again though, you know, that was a lot more anterior delt. I didn't see a lot of chest development because I didn't have that mind-muscle connection. It was all about the weight and not the pec. So stay in the mind-muscle connection, stay in the chest when you're working it, and you'll notice just great results. Steve Cook, BMOC, Swoldier Nation, however you want to say it, chest training 101.